Howdy guys, it's Joe here, and here's a little bit of somber gameplay. Now, if you want to find this gameplay for yourself, you can look in the link in the description below, as this was just from a live stream. Unfortunately for myself, I wasn't able to go to BlizzCon. I didn't get to play Sombra a few days early, but I guess this will really just have to do, and I kind of just want to talk about Sombra in general as a character. Now, of course, Sombra, I've been really excited for. She's looking really cool, and probably going to be an offense that I play quite a bit. Now, a lot of people do kind of compare her to Tracer, but in this gameplay, you can really see that she's not really much like Tracer at all. She's not really much like anyone. I guess her effective range is kind of like Soldier 76, but with the stealth mechanic and with, you know, her hacking mechanic, she doesn't really play like him really at all either, which is actually a pretty interesting thing. The thing that I really like about this character is that she's kind of just her own thing, and I feel like she really can show this just by kind of her playstyles. Now, initially when you look at a character, when you look at someone like Sombra, you'd think, you know, she's a, you know, person that can teleport, a person that's kind of an assassin-y type character. You get behind the enemy team, and you kill them really quickly. But it actually turns out that Sombra doesn't have, you know, the fastest DPS in the game. She doesn't really have way too much burst. She has some pretty nice, you know, like, damage over time, similar-ish to Tracer and similar-ish to, Soldier 76. But she can't just instantly kill people. She doesn't kill people as fast as someone like, you know, Tracer, someone like Genji. Any of these people that are more assassins, she isn't quite like that. Even someone like Reaper, not really exactly the same. But with that said, she still does a decent amount of damage, she still can get behind the enemy team, and she has a lot of potential that she really can do, even though she might not be like an assassin, like people would initially think about a character with a stealth mechanic. Usually you'd think, you know, TF2, spy, get behind them, kill them one hit. No, it's a little bit different. It's actually kind of cool. She's more of like a medium-ish range character. She has a somewhat close effective range to Soldier, as I said before, and that's kind of nice to see out of this character. Now, what that actually means is that often you don't want to get 1 inch away melee range to all these characters. As you can see right here, she got really close to this Reinhardt and completely got taken out. Or I guess he did. That was not the best choice. But yeah, a lot of times you don't want to get way too close to the enemy team, as you don't really have, you know, the most quick escape, I guess you could say. As well with that, I don't know. It just seems like it's a lot better for you to stay at a mid-range and to gank around and get people out of mid-range. Now, as far as the actual, you know, playstyles I'm seeing a lot, especially like in this gameplay and some other gameplays, it seems like the harasser type of Sombra is one that we're seeing a lot. A Sombra that gets behind the enemy team and doesn't exactly go for those quick assassination kills. She more just, you know, takes the enemy's health packs, makes so they can't be used. Sometimes disable some of the really useful enemy abilities, maybe a Reinhardt shield, maybe like a Zenyatta heal orb, a lot of stuff like that, which is really, really useful. And you get behind, you shoot them, you do a little bit of damage, but you don't really go for these tons of kills. I see that really, really often in all these gameplays. Now, with that said, I still do see a decent amount of the assassin version of this character, but often it isn't really quite as good. As you can see right here even, you know, you just really don't, like, burst people super, super fast. You can just see that. You do a decent amount of damage. You do actually quite a bit of damage over a period of time. You do a decent amount of damage, but as far as, you know, like, instant burst, kill them really quick, maybe not the highest. With that said, though, I actually do really like her playstyle. If you watch a lot of these videos, really what you're mainly going to be seeing a lot of is, you know, a harasser and a disruptor, which I guess are kind of two different playstyles. Essentially, you get behind the enemy team, and you either harass them, you do a lot of damage to them, you don't exactly go for kills all the time, but you try to get a lot of damage done, try to really annoy the supports, get people out of the game, try to hack people so then they can't really go a certain part of the map. You can try to do that sort of stuff, and then from there you can also just try to disrupt the enemy team with your ultimate and with your right click. Really, this character is very unique. And very, very interesting is, you'd normally think, you know, like, a stealth character that can, you know, go stealthy and can teleport wouldn't shoot a Reinhardt at this distance. As we see right here, she's shooting from pretty stinking far away at a really medium range. You'd normally expect to be more like Tracer, where you walk, like, 1 inch away from them and just try to get, you know, those melee, like, shotgun type of blasts. With an Uzi, you'd think that, but it's not really how the character works, which is actually kind of cool. Now, another thing that I do kind of like about her is that while her left click is more medium range, her right click does have a little bit less range, and it's kind of closer range. So in order to be, like, a disruptor, sometimes you got a little bit closer, you got to sneak behind in the back line, and then get rid of some of the enemy's abilities. Overall, though, I feel like it's something that's very, very different, and I feel like the playstyle will definitely take a long time to get used to. For a while, I'm really expecting that people are just going to run up, either just melee range, walk really close face on, or that they're just going to try to run behind them and assassinate the enemy team. I don't know if that's going to work way too well. We're really just going to have to see with that. Now, with this all said, though, I feel like she really does have a lot of possibilities that her kit can do, and I feel like she really does have a huge skill cap that is going to come out of this character. Of course, we've only seen gameplay from people playing this character for like 10, 15 minutes, maybe like an hour or 2 hours max. Once we see this character being played a lot more, being played to like more her max potential, I feel like she's really gonna show off as a very, very strong pick, and I feel like we're really gonna see her quite a bit. Now, some people are saying, you know, the second that she comes out to the PTR, she's going to be hotfixed. She's already way too overpowered in this. And some people are saying, you know, she's really not strong enough in this. I feel like we're going to have to wait. But she does seem like she has a huge amount of potential just in her kit. Her kit does so much stuff that only really she can do. And that's just, you know, key to success as far as the character goes. Now, as far as playing Sombra on attack compared to defense, I feel like really one of the main benefits about Sombra on defense is simply the health packs. When you hack a health pack, of course, as we've seen quite a bit in this video, it'll respawn much, much faster. On a place like King's Row, where there's two health packs very close to each other on defense at the beginning point, I feel like that's going to be insanely strong. It'll be essentially like having a third healer while also having a character that has really high DPS, while also having a character that can happen to hack the enemy team and just stop them from being able to use their ultimates or their abilities altogether. And yeah, I feel like that's going to be extremely strong and probably make Sombra very good on certain maps on defense where it just happens to be the health packs are next to each other. Now, on the same note, on offense, I feel like this could also help. But I feel like in general, she's probably going to be a little bit better on offense, as sneaking behind the enemy team does seem a lot better on offense. When you're on defense, sneaking behind the enemy team can be okay. But often if you sneak behind them way too much, you're just killing them at like their spawn and then it takes 6 seconds and they respawn where you just killed them anyway. So kind of a waste of time. So I feel like she will be decent on defense in certain maps, but definitely on offense, she's probably going to be played a lot more. Now, as far as some of the final things I'd like to talk about this character, I feel like the coolest things about her are probably her implications on the meta. Now, as far as we've seen so far, it seems like she might somewhat be able to do, you know, decent against Reinhardt, depending on the situation, and it would be kind of cool to see some jank moments where a Sombra rocks behind a Reinhardt, right-clicks his shield, and then the, you know, defending team just completely wipes the offense team's Reinhardt and their tiny team behind them. That would be pretty cool, but as well with that, I'm really just excited to see Sombra versus people like Lucio, where she can counter his ult, and really just see how Sombra kind of counters other characters in the game. I feel like she will have a lot of potential to counter characters, and as well with this countering potential that she really does have will probably help her make her own team comps. Now, one that I've been really thinking of with my friend in mind, and another friend, is Sombra, Anna, and Soldier 76. Now, this might not seem, you know, like the best thing in the world, but if you've seen the new Soldier 76 on the PTR with Anna boost, you can see how stupid ridiculous that is. You do an insane amount of damage, and the thing that would make this so strong is the simple fact that Sombra with her ultimate can break all barriers and stop people like Reinhardt from making shields, stop people like Winston from making shields. So essentially what you do is you send out the soldier, you send out the Anna. Anna ults the soldier, Sombra's behind the enemy team, invisible. She walks behind them, ults, no one can block the damage. Soldier just walks up and firing squad kills everybody. There we go. Soldier does a billion damage, you kill everyone. I feel like it'll be really cool to see all these different strategies that come out of Sombra. And I do think that she's going to have a lot of different things that she can do. As well, I'm really, really excited to see the different playstyles. As I've really only seen players actually play these three ways, you know, like an assassin, a disruptor, and a harasser. Those are the only ways that I've seen so far. But I kind of want to see a frontline Sombra to see if it works at all. I kind of want to see a Sombra that just tries different jank and see really how it works in game. I don't know. It's something that I'm really, really wanting to see. And I can't wait until Sombra actually comes out of the PTR, I guess into the PTR, so we can check this all out for ourselves. And I guess another thing that I really want to talk about is that I feel like if she is strong, there's going to be a lot of characters that get a little bit more into the meta simply because Sombra's so strong. For example, we're probably going to see a lot more Widowmaker if Sombra's strong, simply because when Widowmaker goes for ultimate, she can see Sombra, she can counter Sombra. As well with this, we'll probably see a lot more Winston if Sombra's a very strong character, as Winston can just randomly shoot around, kind of like the Pyro did against, you know, the Spy in TF2, and just try to find Sombra, as if Sombra takes any damage, well, she's not invisible anymore. I feel like there's a lot of characters that could happen to become a little bit more picked if Sombra did actually, you know, do well in the game, and I really can't wait to see that. Now, as well, I feel like a lot of people are kind of worried that, you know, when Sombra comes out on the PTR, she won't be very good, and I pretty much beg to say that if Sombra is not good on the PTR, Blizzard's probably just gonna, like, immediately buff her as soon as possible. As well, one thing that I want to talk about that we actually just saw in that gameplay, a really cool thing about Sombra, is the simple fact that it's very hard to kill you. As if somebody's attacking you, you can just press your E, and if you have your E next to a health pack, well, you can just go to full health, and it's pretty much impossible to kill you. So that also kind of supports, you know, Widowmaker being good, as if you could just one-shot the Sombra, then there you go, she can't really do way too much. I don't know, I'm really, really excited to see how Sombra changes the meta. Now, of course, Anna did change the meta a lot, but I feel like just the way that Sombra plays will change it so much if she's strong. Adding a stealth mechanic into the game, always having to worry that Sombra might just be around the corner, is something that's really cool. And overall, I feel like her kit does just look really fun and really kind of healthy for the game. I'm really, really glad that Blizzard did not decide to make Sombra like an insta-kill assassin that has stealth. That would have been really annoying in Overwatch. I'm so glad that they didn't do that, and that's just one of the best things about her, in my opinion. Anyways, tell me what you guys think about Sombra. Do you think she's looking like a lot of fun? Are you gonna play Sombra as a character herself, or do you think that she's either too strong or really not strong enough? As well, if you've seen any other playstyles, make sure to tell me, as I want to be ready day one to try to play Sombra to the best of my own ability and just try to do as well as I possibly can. We're just gonna kind of have to wait for that. Anyways, thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, press like and subscribe, and have a wonderful day.